Good morning, children. Today we will study some of the important conventional sources of energy. For example, coal, petroleum, natural gas, and electricity. We'll study about coal first of all. In India, coal is the most abundantly available fossil fuel. Large quantity of coal is available in our country. It provides a substantial part of the nation's energy needs. Almost all the energy needs of our country is met with coal. So it's used for many purposes: power generation, supply the energy to industry, as well as for domestic needs. For example, at homes, also in the rural areas, people use the coal and firewood also for burning purpose and cooking, etc. So domestic needs also met with the coal. India is highly dependent on coal for meeting its commercial energy requirements. For the industrial purpose also, coal is largely used in our country. We know the coal is also formed by the compression of plant materials over millions of years ago. It's a fossil fuel. That means these plant and animal material which are died and buried under the earth are formed into coal. So therefore it is formed a variety of forms depending upon the degrees of compression and the depth of the time of burial. Different types of coal and different quality of coal is available in our country depending upon the how much depth it is buried inside the earth, also how much time it has taken for the formation of such kind of coal. So how these coal is formed from the burial of these animals and plants. These animals and plants which are decayed in many years ago, which is buried inside the earth. In the swamps and marshy lands or wet lands, such kind of plants and animals are buried many years ago, which produce a kind of coal which is known as peat. So peat is a kind of coal which is buried inside the swamps and marshes. So this has very low carbon content and also high moisture, so that it's a low in heating capacity. This is low quality, peat is low quality coal which has low carbon content and also high moisture available in it. So it has also a heating capacity is very lower. Lignite is a low grade brown coal, another one which is also soft with a high moisture content. The principal lignite reserves are found in Nei Valley in Tamil Nadu. These are used for the generation of electricity. Another type of coal, which is another quality of coal, is lignite. Nei Valley is a place in Tamil Nadu where lignite is reserves are largely found. Coal that has been buried deep and subjected to increased temperature. So this is called bituminous coal. Coal which is buried very deeply and it is also increased temperature. You know that bituminous coal which is called. It is the most popular coal in commercial purposes, industrial purposes. Largely bituminous coal is used. It's also most popularly used for the different metallurgical coal also. Okay. Now for the industrial purpose, is largely used by the anthracite, which is called a highest quality coal. In many of these blast furnace and also for smelting in the iron in the blast furnace, the anthracite coal is used. This is the highest quality or the finest quality coal. Now India, in coal also we can find many areas, especially in Chandrapur district it is famous for coal mines also. Large reserves of coal is found in Chandrapur district also. It is also called in India also occurs in the rock series of two main geological ages from the millions of years ago, which was originated or formed in our country. The Gondwana region, we know that the Gondwana area over 200 million years ago, or this was found in the tertiary deposits which are only about 55 million years ago. So in the regions, we know that the Gondwana in the geological age of our Earth, according to the geological ages, Gondwana area are almost 200 million years in age, which was formed. And now also the major resources of the Gondwana coal we are using for metallurgical coal, located that is in the area in our country, which was formed in the many millions of years ago. Now we are extracting, especially some of the regions, locations in our country, Damodar Valley in the West Bengal region, that is also large quantity of coal is available. Then other states are Jharkhand, then also Jharia, Raniganj, Bokaro. These are important coal fields in our country. Godavari and Mahanadi and Son Vardha river valleys, also certain coal deposits are available in our country. We have to locate all these places in the map. So these are the important regions where coal reserves are found in our country. Tertiary coal occur in the northeastern states of Meghalaya, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh and Nagaland. These are the states also tertiary coals occur available. This coal is bulky. We know that coal is a heavy material. It's very bulky also. Also when it is burnt and it becomes ash, so that its bulkiness or the heaviness reduces. So heavy industries and thermal power stations are all located nearby coal, because transportation is becoming very transportation delays occur because it is very heavy, so that problem is in the transportation occur, so that these industries are located nearby the coal mining areas or the coal reserves wherever it is available. Now coming to the another important mineral is petroleum. Petroleum or the mineral oil, this is also next major or second after coal energy resource in India after coal. So it provides a fuel for heat and lighting also, purposefully heat purpose and lighting, and also lubricants for machinery and the raw materials for some other industries like many of the lubricant industries, etc. Petroleum refineries also act as a nodal industry. We know that these are lot of industries naturally occurring based on the petroleum also. For synthetic textiles, fertilizer and many chemical industries also petroleum is used. Different purposes, especially for the lubricants also, petroleum is used. Most of the petroleum occurrences in India are associated with the anticlines and fault traps in the rock formations of the tertiary age. We have studied earlier classes what are anticlines, fault traps, faults and the gaps between the tectonic plates or the lithospheric plates also. So through in these areas, folding and faulting also can be found in interior of the earth, or different shapes, and there are cracks also. Through that, vents or cracks are also found in interior of the earth. So it occurs where it is trapped in the crest of the upfold. Sometimes upfold are occurring due to the movement of these plates inside the earth. So on the crest of this upfold also we can find the oil or petroleum is trapped. Oil bearing layer is porous limestone or sandstone, through which we can find porous sandstone or limestone, which means through these sandstones or limestone oil can be flowing out, because these are porous, or some other some type of soils we also can we have studied about non-porous layers. Non-porous layers are such kind of rocks and stones are available which does not allow the liquids to flow outside. So it is found the petroleum is trapped in the under the non-porous layers. Petroleum is also found in the fault traps between the porous and non-porous rocks also. So gas which is very lighter, that is being lighter, it can occur above the oil also. Petroleum is lying below and there are non-porous rocks also above that, which does not allow the petroleum to flow outside. And natural gas we can find which is very light, so that it can be found above this petroleum. And Mumbai High in India, Mumbai High is a place in the Arabian Sea. Gujarat and Assam, these are the major petroleum producing areas in our country. The major petroleum production is taking place in this region. In Gujarat also, Ankleshwar is the most important field of petroleum production. Assam is the oldest oil producing state in India. Remember that Assam, Gujarat, Mumbai High and the Arabian Sea, these are the important places of the petroleum production centers. Digboi, Nahar Khatia and Moran Kujran, this is in Assam region. These are all important oil fields in the states also. Okay, so natural gas is another important mineral available in our country. It's also an important clean energy resource because without petroleum, this can be used also. It's used as a source of energy as well as the industrial raw material. It is used as energy and industrial raw material also in the petrochemical industry largely used. Natural gas is considered an environment friendly because it does not pollute the air much because low carbon dioxide emissions are there. So that it does not pollute the air or atmosphere much. So the fuel for the present century, we mostly use the natural gas. Large reserves of natural gas has been discovered in the Krishna Godavari basin. In the Krishna Godavari river basin, largely natural gas reserves are found. Along with the west coastal regions, reserves of the Mumbai High and allied fields of supplementary by fields of the Gulf of Cambay in the north western region of our country. And Andaman Nicobar Islands are also important areas where large reserves of natural gas is available. About 1700 kilometers long Hazira Vijaypur Jagdishpur cross country gas pipeline links Mumbai High to Basin. Okay, this is also with the fertilizer, power and industrial complexes in the western and the northern regions of India is located in this region because this is 1700 kilometers long Hazira Vijaypur Jagdishpur cross country gas pipeline which connects from Mumbai to Basin region also. Okay, so these regions, there are important industrial complexes in the western and northern India are located. So this artery or these pipeline connections or link providing an impetus to industrial India's gas production. Very important for the production of gas industries in our country. So the power and fertilizer industries are the key users of natural gas. Natural gas is largely used by the industry, fertilizer and power industries also. Now, you can see here, in the modern world, we often say about CNG or the natural gas, compressed natural gas for vehicles and also it can use instead of liquid gas. It's also now gaining wide popularity in the country because CNG is compressed natural gas is used in the vehicles instead of petroleum. And electricity is another important resource for our country that such many different purposes we are using nowadays in our country. So for the development of our industries also largely electricity is necessary. It is generated mainly in two ways by running water which drives into hydro turbines to generate hydroelectricity. Hydel power or hydroelectricity by using water we are generating. And another one is burning other fuels like coal or petroleum and natural gas also which can drive the turbines to produce thermal power. Two ways, hydroelectricity and thermal electricity are produced in our country. So once this electricity is generated exactly and electricity is exactly the same when whether it is thermal electricity or hydroelectricity, when it is produced, electricity will be same only. Hydroelectricity is generated by fast flowing water. We know that from the waterfalls or the dams canals are constructed, which can be water is highly flowing down on the falling on the turbines and producing the electricity. So which is a renewable resource. Water can be is a renewable resource. India has number of such kind of multi-purpose projects like the Bhakranangal, Damodar Valley Corporation, the Kopili Hydel project producing hydroelectric power. So these are the multi-purpose projects, many different purposes for generating electricity or irrigation purposes, etc. These projects are constructed from that we are generating electricity. Thermal electricity is also generated by using coal, petroleum and natural gas, etc. So thermal power stations are used non-renewable fossil fuels for generating electricity also. So that's all about the conventional sources of energy, importantly coal, petroleum, natural gas and electricity. So tomorrow we will study more about the non-conventional sources of energy. That's all for today. Thank you.